So in the previous session, our task was how to convert the Python file to the .exe file. That was really the good initiative. Like suppose we are having the Python program and I want to give the Python program to someone and he don't have the Python, nothing is installed over there. In that case, what you can do, you can just create the .exe file and you can give it to the client and they can just click on that .exe file and it will get executed for them. They don't need to install the Pythons and all of it. That's good. Now, today what I'm going to start with, I'm just going to looking for the packaging of the Python project. Packaging means what? Tell me one thing. From last few months, we are working on the Python. Every time to install the individual package, we need to write pip install numpy. What does it mean? It will install this particular package with you. Suppose I am going to write pip install pandas. It will install this package for you. So, can we create our own package that can be installed using the pip command? My question is, like naturally, these are the packages created by some developers and all. So, my question is, can we create this particular package so it can be installed by the other user and they can use it like the imported package? So how we can do this? This is the agenda for the today, like today's refreshment. Now the thing is that what we need to do, we just need to packaging the Python project, or what I am saying, like I need to use the setup tool for the Python package. So how we can do that? Okay, I am just going to start with this. So after this, suppose I need to give some code to the other users and all, what I need to do, suppose my other teammate is there and I need to share my code and all, what I will do, I will just create the package, I will write the functions and all, and I will create some package kind of a stuff over there and they just need to install it, pip install and the name of the package. Every function will get over there. So that's basically we need to do. So how we can do that? I'm going to start with that. First of all, I'm just going to create a folder in the particular drive. I'm just going to create a folder in the E drive. So right click, new and folder. And I'm just going to give the name of this folder like we are getting the setup and all. So I'm just going to give the name like setup p. Okay, it's fine, it can be anything. Under the setup p, what I'm going to do, the first file I'm going to create over there, the first folder I'm going to create over there, right click, new folder. First of all, I need to think like what package we are looking for. So I'm just going to give the name of the package. Suppose I'm going to give the name of the package like package Santosh. I'm going to create my package. I'm just going to give the name like package Santosh. And within package Santosh, okay, it's fine. Now I'm going to create another file. I'm going to create a text file. Remember, if we are going to create the setup and all, in every setup file there will be the readme file, there will be the license.txt file. So I'm just going to fulfill the formalities again. New text document, and I'm going to create the document like readme.txt, and again I'm going to create a document called text document over there, and this document will be license.txt, license.txt. So we are having the license.txt file is there, we are having the readme.txt file is there, we are having the package Santosh folder is there. That's good. And okay, so this is the folder, setup folder is with me. Under the setup folder, these are the folders like package Santosh, license and readme. And better, I'm going to start with the PyCharm. I'm just going to open the PyCharm, because in the PyCharm everything will be there in front of you. So in the better way you can understand like what's going on. So I'm just going to open the PyCharm. In the PyCharm, I'm just going to open the project. And my project is there within the E drive. Open. It was there in the E drive, and the name of the folder was like I need to refresh. Yeah, I'm just going to select this particular folder. Now everything is there in front of me, like this is the setup P, and this is the package Santosh. License.txt file is there, readme.txt file is there. That's good. What I'm going to do, I'm going to create a file over there, a Python file, init.py. So I'm just going to start, right click, new, and I'm going to create a file called Python file, and I'm going to give the name of the file, like underscore underscore init underscore underscore dot py. Click on this. We don't need to give the extension .py, it's already Python file, but it's fine. So within that particular folder, I'm going to create the file underscore underscore init underscore underscore dot py, and I'm going to write a function over there. And it can be anything. I'm just going to put the simple functions over there, like function, and I'm going to give the name of my function is like my function. And I'm going to pass function, my function. Oh, sorry. I'm just going to use def my function, and I'm going to pass the parameters over there. Like I'm just going to give the number colon, and I'm just going to give the message like print welcome in Python setup. That's fine, anything you can write. And I'm just going to apply like return the number. You can do anything with this particular function, like any complicated thing can be there. I'm just writing the two line of functions over there just for your reference. So this is my function, that's it. It's good. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create the another Python package, another file, right click, new. And this is my file. I'm going to create a Python file, and I'm just going to give the name of the file like setup.py. This is the main file we are having. So I'm going to create a file called setup.py. Yeah, this is the setup.py we are having. Now the first thing what we need to do, I need to write few lines of code over there. So I'm just going to write from, and we are having the separate package over there like setup tools. So I'm just going to write from setup tool, and what we need to import, I just need to import setup. Perfectly fine. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write setup. I'm just going to write setup, and within this setup, I'm going to pass all the parameters over there, all the attributes over there. So I'm just going to give the name. Name is equal to what will be the name of your package. So my package name is package Santosh. I'm going to give comma, and again I'm look. Every package must have some versions and all. So I'm just going to give the version, and version I'm going to give like 1.0. It's fine. It can be anything, but ideally it should start from 1.0. I'm going to start with, and then I'm going to give the detailed description. It's a description over there. Description, and in the description I'm going to give the detail about this my package, like this is the refreshment package. That's good. And comma, you can put the detailed description, like the long description you can put. So I'm just going to give like long underscore description. In the long description you can put multiple lines over there. So in the long descriptions, I'm just going to write like, this is the refreshment package. It can be anything you can put over there. This is the, and better leave it blank right now. Okay. Now we can also put the name of the author, like author is equal to, and suppose I'm going to give my name over there, like Santosh the Great. Yeah, I'm just writing over here like Santosh the Great is the author of this package, even though this package is going to do nothing, but again nothing wrong with that. Okay, so this is the author. And now the important thing is there, I need to mention the package. Package is equal to, and what are the package we are having? My package name was package Santosh. So this package Santosh folder, I'm just going to give like packages, and I package it. It's not the package, it can be the multiple packages over here. So I'm just going to give name like package Santosh. Now again I'm going to give like other parameters over there, like if some additional attributes is required over there. Suppose your this particular program is going to import the pandas, if this particular program is going to import the NumPy, in that case what you also require the NumPy and pandas to install. So what we can do, we can put over there like comma. I'm just going to put install underscore requires underscore requires. So if the other installation is required, that I need to mention over there. So I'm just writing install underscore requires is equal to, right now we don't need to any additional components over there, so I'm just going to put the bracket. That's it, this line get completed for me. So this is the setup functions I'm calling. And I'm just going to pass the name of the package, the version, I'm going to put the description, and I'm going to put the long description, even the author. I'm just going to mention the package name over there. And I'm just also mentioning like if additional requirement will be there, I'm just going to put like install underscore require. That's good. Okay, that's it. So this is my function. And this is my setup.py. Under the setup.py, these things are there. I'm going to start with the terminal. This is my terminal. Yeah, I'm on the terminal. I just, what need to do? I'm just going to start with, I need to run this file, this particular file. So I'm just going to write Python setup.py, setup.py. Before the setup.py, it will be better do one thing, install the wheel package over there. So I'm writing pip install, and I'm just writing wheel. This is required for this installation, it will create the wheel. So I'm just going to install this particular package over there, it's already there with my system. So you need to do this. Now what I'm going to write, I'm just going to write Python setup.py, and I'm just going to write sdist source destination, and I'm just going to write bdist build destination. It's a source destination, it's a build destination. Sdist and bdist underscore underscore fill, enter. Yeah, package get created for me. Now you can check it out, just refresh this. Yeah, multiple folder is there. See, build is there, good. We are having dist is there, that's good. In the dist, we are having this will. This is for the distribution purpose. And this is basically the source, sdist and bdist. This is the build destination, and this is the source destination. We don't need to understand what exactly is that. What I'm trying to say, like, okay, these things are there. Now, everything is ready for me. I don't need to do anything. Right now, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to install my package. So how we can install my package now? I'm just going to write pip install just select this particular will file. So I'm just going to get the name. I'm just going to copy this name over from there, and I'm just going to put like pip install. Oh, nothing get copied over there. Rename. Yeah, Control C. Run this. Oh, I'm just going to put the name over here. Yeah, enter. So you are installing your own package. Yeah, it can install for me. Now, how I can check it out? No. This is not correct. It's not working. The problem is our file is there in the dist folder, and right now we are under this setup folder. So I need to come in that particular folder, then it will get installed. CD dist. Not on this. Yeah, it's installing your package. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write Python over there. Python. In this particular Python, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write import, and what was the name of the package? My package name was package Santos. So I'm just going to write import package Santos. And now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to call the function, and my function was like my function. So I'm just calling this function, my function over there, and I'm just going to pass the number. Run this function. Yeah, it's working perfectly fine. But this is the another package. It's not this particular package, it's another package, because we are not getting this particular message over there. Welcome in Python setup. Okay, do one thing. Now it's created earlier. So I'm just going to exit this. I'm just going to exit this, uninstall this. So I'm writing pip uninstall. Yeah, yes, I'm going to write Python. I'm going to check it out whether the installation gets successfully or not. I'm writing import, and the package name was, copy this, I'm writing import, paste over here. We are getting the message like no module name package Santos. It's not there. You need to install that because you uninstalled earlier. Exit from this and install this now. Yeah, it's installing. Now it's get installed. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to write Python. Run this, import. Yeah, working fine perfectly. Package Santos, and my function name was my function. So I'm just going to call this my function over there. Yeah. Oh, I need to pass the parameter also. So I'm just calling this function in this terminal and passing the parameters over there. Unexpected. What is the problem? Oh, some spaces are there. Yeah, we are getting the message welcome in Python setup 222. This was written over there, welcome in Python setup, and we are getting the message 222. So your package get installed. Okay, I'm just going to explore the few things over there. See, in this particular file, this is the source.txt. The source is coming from this file. The source is coming from this file. This is the package information, name, version, summary. This is the refreshment package, home package, unknown. Author, Santos the Great. Oh, they are fine. author email, nothing is there, license it's unknown, description unknown, platform unknown. So this is the metadata it's contained. We don't need to do anything, we just need to execute this file, that's it. Now, what I want to do, I want to upgrade my package. Like some upgradation is there. Suppose I'm going to make some modifications with this function. Right now in this function, you are writing only these things over there. So what I want to do, I want to make some modifications over there. So I'm going to create another function over there might be. And I'm going to put some another function over there. Might be I can create the class and all. So suppose I'm going to create another function called def my function 1. Here I'm writing welcome in Python setup. Next version. Yeah. Return number. So we are having the two functions over there. One is my function and one is my function 1. So the modification is there in the package. Now, if I'm going to put any modifications, one important thing that we need to do, we need to change the versions over there. So I'm going to change the version like 1.1. 1.1. See, this is here we are getting the message like 1.0, 1.0. I'm going to change the version like 1.1. Versioning is basically it's a different kind of topic, like we are having the multiple kind of things that we need to consider under the version. Versioning basically it's an under topic. But right now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to assign the versions over there, like the major version, minor version, lot of things we need to check. I'm just going to give it, it's a minor version. If I'm going to make it like 2.0, means this major changes is there. Yes, the major changes is there. We are having the two different functions now. Earlier it was only one function. So I'm just going to create another version, like version 2.0. That's good. Once again, do the things, install this package. Run the program. I'm just going to write python setup.py sdit and bdit will. It will not get executed because my setup.py is available within the setup folder. So better just go one step back. Yeah, we are in the one step back. Run the command. Python setup.py sdist bdist. Enter. See, 2.0 versions get created for me. Check it out. Yeah, we are having the two different versions over there. So this is the first version and this one is the second version. If I'm going to check the informations over there, like see package information, this is the latest one, that information we are having. Now what I'm going to do, I don't need to go through this particular files and all, it's perfectly fine. Now what I need to do, I'm going to install this. So I'm writing cd dist and I'm just going to use pip install. Pip install and my package name is now 2.0. Earlier it was 1.0. So I'm just going to give like 2.0. Check it out. See, it's going to uninstall the previous one. See, uninstalling the previous package and then successfully, after the uninstalling, it's going to complete this successfully installed package Santosh 2.0. That's good. Import again. I'm just going to write Python. Once again, I'm going to write like import package Santosh. Earlier, only one function was there. And now I'm going to write package Santosh. I'm going to call this function, my function 1. And I'm going to pass the number over there. Yeah, we are getting welcome in Python setup next version. If I want to execute the previous command, like the previous function, yeah. Welcome in Python setup. So this is how you can make the enhancement. This is all about the Python setup package. Now you can explore a lot of things are there, but this is the minimum thing, and more or less this is the maximum thing that you people need to learn, need to understand, like how we can create the Python package.